I would like to thank all of you for being part of this noble cause. I wanted to ask all of you guys to today think and open your heart and wallets as well. So we can help Pakistan, we can help the people in Pakistan. I wanted to introduce one of the finest men in the DC, Maryland, and Washington area. He has been the executive director of Common Grounds. He has been a teacher for all of us. He has so many meetings with the Imam of Kaaba. He has been inspiration. Please join me in welcoming Dr. Zulfikar Kazmi. Please come on the stage and take over from here. Thank you, Dr. Zulfikar.
Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. In the name of Allah, the most merciful and beneficent. Ladies and gentlemen, it's a privilege and honor for me to greet you and to welcome you here. In my humble viewpoint, it's a very blessed evening that we are here to understand the sufferings of the people, to know that what is going on in many countries, including Pakistan, and what is happening in Pakistan just because of lack of resources and lack of health facilities in Pakistan. But how people are taking a standpoint and working very hard to facilitate all those people who they are the sufferers. This evening, we are very much privileged and honored to have one very eminent person. By profession, he is a professor and teacher. And teacher and professor of, and as a specialist of cancer disease, he has a big name. Everyone knows about him in our region, in South Asia. He is professor of oncology, and meanwhile, he has taken a great initiative that he will be building up one Pakistan's largest cancer care hospital. This is what we need in Pakistan. We have some good examples in Pakistan. Definitely, Imran Khan, you know, took initiative and he built up one great hospital in Pakistan, Shaukat Khanum. But it was not enough to serve the people. This gentleman, Dr. Shahryar, you know, made a commitment with himself and with the people of Pakistan that he will be giving a state-of-the-art hospital in Pakistan about cancer that will be the largest facility for the cancer patients. I'm very delighted and honored to invite him at the stage. Please come at the stage and definitely what we say to you sometimes. ज़ियारत करते हैं ऐसे लोगों की, ऐसे लोगों की हम ज़ियारत करते हैं, ऐसे लोगों को देख के we feel blessed that these kind of people are in our society who they are working for a great cause and to help the cancer patients. Definitely, when we talk about people, the best person and best people are those who they are helping others. I have seen many people in Washington DC that who they talk about human rights, who they talk about dignity of women, who they talk about inter-religious cooperation, and who they talk about that how we could bring people together just for one purpose, and that's a peace. And he is also helping others to understand what is the meaning of religion actually, you know. Basically, he is the president, he is the chairman of the Washington Times, very eminent person, a beautiful human being, a great friend of mine, Mr. Tom McDavid. I'll be requesting him to please join Dr. Shandar on the stage. Ladies and gentlemen, in every walk of life, we have seen some women are making us proud because of their work. And leaving behind women in our society is the biggest reason of suffrage, that we are not empowering our women, that we are not using their abilities, we are not recognizing them properly. But Dr. Shahyar is the one. He identified one person in Pakistan and keeping along him, keeping along her, you know, one great human being, Mrs. Radhana Tariq. I'll be asking her to please come and do it. Dr. Radhana, Mrs. Radhana Tariq. Yes. We always start with the name of the Creator, who is not a creator but compassionate, and He is merciful. This is my very humble request to Hafiz Saeed Saab. Please open this beautiful gathering and meeting with the recitation of Holy Quran. Hafiz Saeed Saab, and please also give the translation of Holy Quran.